Charles Bukowski, The Young Man on the Bus Stop Bench. He sits all day at the bus stop at sunset in Western, his sleeping bag beside him. He's dirty. Nobody bothers him. People leave him alone. The police leave him alone. He could be the second coming of Christ, but I doubt it. The soles of his shoes are completely gone. He just laces the tops on and sits and watches traffic. I remember my own youthful days, although I traveled lighter. They were similar. Park benches, street corners, tar paper shacks in Georgia for $1.25 a week, not wanting the Skid Row church handouts, too crazy to apply for relief. Daytimes spent lounging in public parks, bugs in the grass biting, looking into the sky, little insects whirling above my head, the breathing of white air, just breathing and waiting. Life becomes difficult, being ignored and ignoring everything turns into white air. The head fills with white air. And as invisible women sit in rooms with successful, bright-eyed young men, conversing brilliantly about everything, your sex drive vanishes and it really doesn't matter. You don't want food, you don't want shelter, you don't want anything. Sometimes you die, sometimes you don't. As I drive past the young man on the bus stop bench, I am comfortable in my automobile. I have money in two different banks. I own my own home. But he reminds me of my younger self, and I want to help him, but I don't know what to do. Today, when I drove past again, he was gone. I suppose, finally, the world wasn't pleased with him being there. The bench still sits there on the corner, advertising something.